Hello and welcome to the first part of How to Play Production Line. This video builds on the lessons learned during the first part and will attempt to explain the mid-game of Production Line. During this video we will be ramping up production, managing sales price premiums, setting up research and development, adding features to cars to increase our profits, increase our productivity with new process technologies and serving different market segments. So let's start by loading up a game, which will be the end of the previous tutorial. And during this tutorial we set the basic production line, which is producing about 2 cars per hour at 50% efficiency. And these cars are basic models which have no additional features at all. So let's see where we want to end up. And for that I'll load in the end of this tutorial. So I'll skip ahead to the end. And then I'll show you. Basically, this is about the same layout with some changes. And now we're actually at 70% efficiency. We're also making a profit. And we have now 3 different models to sell to our customers. So we're actually using different market segments. And the mid-range car, for example, has air conditioning heaters and leather interior, whereas the budget car lacks the air conditioning and heater. And that is how we are segmenting our cars to our customers. We've also greatly increased the number of cars we use. We've increased this to 10 cars per hour. So as you can see, the factory floor is quite busy. We now have research and development over here. We're producing different models at the chassis assembly. We've added additional robot upgrades to the fit body slots. And we split up the fit seats, fit accessories from the previously known one in all station, which took 40 minutes, to different substations, which only take 3 minutes apiece. So this is now we know where we want to end up. So let's talk about a little bit about why we want to end up here. So the first thing which is important to realize is that in this game you pay a lot of rent. So for example, for only renting this floor, so you can rent additional space, but only renting this floor is 10k per hour. So if you're only producing 2 cars per hour, that means each car has to provide 5k of rent, right? Because the rent has to be paid anyway. So now we're producing 10 cars per hour, so that means we only have to assign 1k of rent for each car produced. Now as we keep expanding the factory and producing more cars, we want to use these economies of scale to increase our profits. But keep in mind that this game has market segments, so right now you can see that there are 8 mid-range cars piling up in the showroom, and that can be explained by the customers that are visiting the store. So there is a number of customers which will visit your store, and there's also a total market share. So there are basically just less customers interested in more expensive cars. The budget cars will always sell better, and the expensive cars only has 8 customers per hour, and the luxury cars is even less. It's 1 customer per hour right now. Okay, so let's hurry up. So we'll go back to the end of the tutorial and I'll try to take you through the entire process as fast as possible. It was the first time I tried this, the video took three quarters of an hour, and that's a bit of long. So we start by pumping up production. We need cash. So first check out the loan. Ooh, that's cool. So right now we have very, very interesting loans available, which is 1.8 million for 9%, 1 million for 6%, and 1.6 million for 8%. This might not look that interesting, but when you take the first loan, for example this one, then eventually the other ones will be replaced by less interesting loans. So for the purpose of this tutorial, I'll just take these two loans, and then we can end up with 3 million in cash. So I'm taking a bit of risk here, but I know what I'm doing, so just bear with me. So let's start by adding the research and development, because that's what we need to get get the features going. Now, normally I recommend only starting with about 5 of these guys, because again, you need the economies of scale to pay the wages of these guys. But we just loaned about 3 million, so let's take a gamble. So, the research tree is composed of two parts, the process part and the technologies part. The interesting features are located in the technologies part. For example, the air conditioning is located over here. And we'll add that to the queue. Right. For the other features, usually you need different technologies. For example, to install leather interior, we also need the accessory specialization. And the accessory specialization is listed on the process tree. And this allows you to split up the accessory production and thereby also unlock the leather interior research. So now we've added everything to queue. We start with environmental features, then we go to air conditioning, accessory specialization, and leather interior. So to fund our researchers, we need to produce more cars. And right now our bottleneck is over here. This guy's running at 98% of his capacity. It's producing the sedan. So we're going to add, you see I start with one additional guy. Could be we need two later on. So we have the conveyor belts. Now remember the ratios from the previous tutorial. So fit body, 31 minutes. Chassis assembly, 12 minutes, so that's a 3-to-1 ratio. So we already know we need additional units. So there we go. Now we add the stockpile. We connect the exits. We connect the conveyors to the resource network. We connect the different stockpiles. Obviously we have to add stuff to our stockpile, so we use the fit copy from slot button. The fit body that will just add everything we need. It's also that over here. Now we're ready to watch our factory grow. So the researchers are busy. We've now 21 research points at 1 point per minute. And the chassis are now producing cars. Right now there are 3 cars in the showroom. Let's check out the market segment. There's a 12% market share for budget cars. We're currently producing 2 per hour, we're selling 0 cars, and there are 12 customers. So that actually indicates that our prices are not right. So we have to lower our price premium to make the car more interesting to the visiting customers per hour. It would be nice to have a single sale, but there we go. We just sold the car. So there we go. The next hub will be the painter. Again, the painter is 34 minutes, whereas the fit body is 31 minutes. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we need at least 5 painters, or else we get a pileup like this. Well, we can actually compact this. Oops, deleted a few cars, got more mounts. So there we go. Now, during the pre-show, I noticed I left not enough space over here. Actually, I would like to move these guys a bit back. So I'm just gonna keep a bit of space over here. Move them back by two items. So we can move the supply over here. Like that. We can change the conveyor belt like that. So then we end up with more space for the fit accessory slot, which we will be researching pretty soon. don't forget to add something to the stockpile. Okay, looks good. This guy looks kind of busy, so let's go ahead, add another importer. Keep in mind that the game will try to use the resource importer that's closest. So unless there's a really big queue, it will not use this guy over here. Okay, so we need another painter. Keep in mind that when you dozer over a car, it will actually destroy the car that was on that spot, so it just destroyed two cars. And again, we're waiting for the research on the air conditioning. Ah, there we go. Cool. So now we have completed the air conditioning. We can have it installed over here. So it's a new subslot of the accessory. So just add it like this. This guy is now 40 minutes and this guy is 2 minutes, so that will be no problem. Well, it might be even smarter to put it over here next to the electronics. Simply because we might need a second fit accessory slot at some point, because that will be 15 minutes. So let's change it like this. Okay. Now the interesting part. We need to add this feature to our car design. So we go to the car designer. We add the air conditioning. If you take a look at this, the sales price used to be 21k. We add the air conditioning and it's 28k. So actually 7k is added to the sales price. Now, this can be explained because the air conditioning currently has a 98% premium. So there's a 2K market value, there's a 2K premium, which makes it 4.7K, but we also have the 35% sales price premium, which is applied over that. So that's why we end up with a difference of 7K. Now, everything above 25K is considered mid-range. If you go even further, then you will see that the car will become expensive. Now, remember that marketing data from before? Over here. Over here. There's the budget market, the mid-range market, and the expensive market. So there are 15 customers per hour for the budget market and 9 customers per hour for the mid-range market. So currently, we can sell our cars at a 35% premium, and it happens that this will be a mid-range car. So the first thing we need to do is rename this model and recognize it's a mid-range car. Then we add a similar model, so that includes it. And now we don't include the air conditioning, and we add the same 35% premium. So now we have actually two different models which we throw at the market. And right now, if we look at the market, there's 15 to 9 filters, so we should be producing a bit more budget cars. So keep that in mind. So we go to the chassis assembly, we change the schedule, and we add 2 budget cars. So now it will go from producing the mid-range to the budget. There you go, budget. So we do the same for the other slots. That's the budgets, and soon we will have different types of cars running through our factory. Now go to stockpile. Oops, there is no air conditioning available. So We wanted to have economies of scale, so let's add another chassis assembly. The two budget cars. Okay. Looks like our fit engine slot is now the bottleneck. It's actually quite a bad design over here. Because the cars will pile up before the slot. But this will hurt. But I will have to stop production and fix this. I have to move this guy back a bit. Because else cars will just pile up here in these gaps. I'll move the entry here. And as soon as these guys are finished, I'll fix that one here as well. Cool. Now the accessory specialization. I wanted to wait to fix this, but for the purpose of this tutorial I'll just destroy this. I don't recommend you doing that, I recommend you waiting till the guys have finished it for now. We just fix this so we can continue with the tutorial. So we add the fit engine. It's basically just an error of the original tutorial where the spacing was bad. Okay, it's much better. Soon we can move this guy. So that's what it's all about. So these guys are almost done. So now we have the new options. So we have the dashboard we can add, the air conditioning, the windscreen, the seats, the horn, and the lights. And these are all individual workstations. So that means we're actually greatly enhancing our productivity because this guy was 5 workers doing 15 minutes, and these guys are all 3 minutes, 3 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 2 minutes. So that's much quicker over here. Don't forget the conveyor belts. And once these guys are done, we can remove this extra fit air conditioning. Okay, we can fix this mistake. And there we go. Let's take a look at the research. So we're now researching the final research, which was good, which was the leather interior to further increase our profits. After that, let's talk about some efficiency enhancements. So we can add the more robots research. And then in the future, we can add additional features such as the heater or the central locking or the car alarm, stuff like that. Looks like we need a motor engine. Cool. So, I will not press this button, but we've now researched better interior. Sorry about that. So, let's take a look here. The fifth seat slot, there's now an upgrade. Leather interior. So, now it will start importing 2 units of leather for every car. And again, we go to the car designer and check out the mid-range model. Boom. We just added 3K to the pricing. For the budget car, again, mid-range is too expensive, but leather, yep, we can do it. So we can add leather to the budget model. And we will. So every car that's now in production line. So the orange cars are now the mid-range models and the green cars are now the budget models. So they will get the leather interior over here. So this guy already has the leather interior listed. And now it has the air conditioning listed. And then it will just head to this part. Electronics, but we haven't researched any important electronics yet. For example, you could add navigation, stuff like that, music, keyless entry, Bluetooth, stuff like that. And now we export the car. And there we go. So this guy doesn't have air conditioning or leather interior yet. This guy likes leather interior. Leather interior and everything is considered mid-range. So we have 12 mid-range cars now in the showroom. But our new ratio was actually 2 to 1. Ah, there we go. More robots. Well, this is an important research because it allows you to balance your factory even further. Don't press this option. It isn't expensive, but it will mess you up. Let's explain why. So, for example, this is the future of your factory, having individual stations instead of these large, easy-to-use stations, because then you can add the different features and you have enhanced productivity. But take a look at the balancing. 3 minutes, 3 minutes 30 seconds, 3 minutes 45 seconds, 4 minutes, 2 minutes. So that means that this guy is actually waiting for next vehicle running, waiting for next slot. So it doesn't make sense to add a 10% speed boost to the guy doing 3 minutes when further in down the line there's one guy taking 4 minutes. So let's upgrade only this guy and the other one and boom. So now the slowest time in our line is 3 minutes 32 seconds. So there are no further stations that need upgrading. So the downside of upgrading this guy would be that the power consumption is increased. And now it isn't. So on the other slots, this isn't true because the fit engine slots are still the basic models. Eventually we will tech more and then we'll get the individual stations, which have different timings and different balancing needs. But right now, these are basic slots, so we upgrade everything that has a queue. And just makes them a lot more efficient. Same is true for this guy. Fit body slot, 31 minutes, now 28 minutes. But that's really nice. And depending on how much chassis we need, you can also increase the chassis assembly, but it looks like we already have piling up here. Oh, don't forget the new research. So we increase the robots. There's also a research called Even More Robots. Some other important techs include the improved efficiency, which unlocks stuff like faster resource imports and faster conveyor belts and faster overhead conveyors. Especially this one will decrease the downtime. It will decrease the waiting for resource. So that's very important. Another important factor is the power production, because if we look at our expenses, we'll see that the power purchase is a significant part. Right now it's 26K. It's about a quarter of our total spend. And the next thing you should aim for is the component purchase. The component purchase are all the imports listed over here at the import spectrum. So if you look at the 24 hours spent, we're spending 75k on door panels, 12k on power trains per hour, 9k on door panels per hour, 8k on tires per hour. So these are things you can eventually start reducing yourself by going down in the resource trees. For example, here we have seat manufacturing, sunroof manufacturing. Basically, you can just manufacture almost anything yourself. Here's the wheel manufacturing, tire manufacturing. But it will take a lot of resource points. So, at the start of the game, I recommend you focusing on adding more money instead of reducing your cost, because adding the air conditioning will add 4 to 7k to your model, whereas saving a few bucks on lights, well, it doesn't really help your company at all. Only when the competition is tough, then you need to focus on cost. So right now, let's take a look. So we have 600k and we're starting to make money. So if I stop spending like crazy, then we will end up making money. If I sell these 12 cars, we end up making money. We could go for the power plants. And there are no interesting loans available currently. Probably game thinks we can't handle more money. So that means the power plants, they're not as interesting because they cost about 10 to 20k each. We need about 20 of them, so basically most of our capital will disappear into the power plants. Maybe if we hit 1 million, then it will be interesting. So for now, let's check out if we can maybe add some more features to the car. Here, for example, this one is easily implemented because you already have the accessory specialization and we already have the subtree. So for 250 points, we add another 1 to 2k by adding a heater. This one is also pretty interesting, the Nepa leather seats. It adds 6k to our cost. But after this, I think we can go for either the body specialization, which splits up the expensive production over here, or we can go again for the power plant, but we'll see. I think the tutorial is almost done, by the way, because we sort of ended up with the save that showed the end of the tutorial. Let's see if we can make a profit over here, and if not, it would be interesting to see where we can go. So for example, I can see there's an imbalancing over here. This won't be smart because we can actually add more pins like this in the future and make them go around. So for now, I'll put an additional painter over here. Oops, don't want to destroy this car. Okay, there we go. If you want, you can actually make these cars go around. It's not always recommended. And if you drag a belt over here and then make it come back over here, they will go around. This is looking very good. 97%. Our efficiency is now at 71%. So that's the first milestone we reached. Our objective here was to increase our productivity. So we're now at 71% slots running with 9 vehicles produced per hour. Looks like cars are piling up, so that means our sales price is a bit too high. So again, remember the market segment. We're now selling 6 cars per hour and we're producing 7 cars per hour. And the budget cars are still only produced by 2 units per hour. So that's basically the lag that's in the factory. So it took a while for all the old mid-range cars to sell out, and then it took a while for all the new models from the chassis, the budget chassis, to end up in the showroom. But right now we see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 green cars, but only one orange car. So let's reduce to 25%. And we can remove this slot, of course. It's also leftover from the old accessory slot. So to summarize what we accomplished right now. So first we added the research and development, which is now researching heater, which will be added to our car models in the future to increase our sales price and decrease our profits. We added different chassis assembly units and we balanced our factory. We added additional painters, we added additional fit body, we added additional engines. We made sure there are plenty of stockpiles. We also added the robots to some of our stations, for example the windscreen. And the seats now have additional robots. Also, the fit engine slots have additional robots. And they're now installing air conditioning and leather seats to our cars. This has greatly enhanced the number of cars we're producing per hour. Let me show you the trick. And again, I don't recommend keeping this on for too long, because eventually they're just driving around in circles. It's not even working. Okay. Why not? Maybe they updated this to prevent the circle method, that's possible. There's some tiny balancing issues we need to sort out here, because we now have the 3 assembly yards, so we need one additional fit body to even things out. It rains on 7k. I need to produce more of the budget cars, which should be alright soon. Soon the green cars will be in the showroom and the orange cars will get sold eventually. If you now lower the price of the orange car, they'll actually be known as budget. So for example, if you lower. So this model will stay mid-range, but in the showroom itself, it doesn't have the leather interior, so then eventually it will actually be recognized as a budget model. So to keep it in mid-range, I have to give it at 25%. Okay. I think this should give you a pretty good idea on how to get the economies of scale needed in production line, how to get to 74% slots running with 10 vehicles produced per hour, which allows you to have a large R&D force without losing money. And there we go. It was a bit above the zero. And yeah, now we can just keep playing game, making more money, adding more features, which will just take a bit of time, just keep adding features, and then you make more and more money, then eventually you can hire these additional spots here. You can split out, for example, your painting, which is very, very slow. Just take a complete hole and just fill it with the different steps of the paint, dry finish, undercoat, polishing. And then you end up producing 40 or even more cars. Okay, good luck in game, and if you have any further questions, just leave them in the comments. Thank you for watching.